The environment of Waterloo is really positive for innovators and entrepreneurs.
It seems like a very friendly, supportive environment.
So I'm very happy to be in a place that supports research and allows us to have the freedom.
It encourages research in a wide variety of areas. It encourages research with industry, not only academic research, that is research that is of academic interest only, but it still allows fundamental research as well.
The computer science departments come in different types and flavors, dictated in great respect with their size. So this department is huge. We have a huge number of undergraduates, we have a substantial number of graduate students, and we have a significant number of faculty members. What that really means is that when I want to collaborate with somebody who's an expert in some area, I don't need to look very far. I can find somebody on the faculty who's an expert.
I also like being in a faculty of mathematics, which means that it's very easy to go over and talk to my colleagues who are in the Department of Combinatorics and Optimization, for example. And then also, just in general, I found that the people in the school have been very, very supportive. So any project that I've wanted to pursue, no matter how crazy it is, I've always had support and people saying, you know, to go for it.
The policy that lets us hold our own intellectual property is part of the innovative spirit here.
It's a reflection of sort of the support that the University of Waterloo provides, and that they have allowed me freedom to pursue whatever my research interests have been. And I think that leads to sort of good research, both for myself as well as many other people in the school.
I was motivated mostly by my graduate students. I followed them. When I meet a new graduate student who wants to work with me, we spend quite a bit of time trying to find out what they're interested in, and they bring me to something new.
I think the 50th anniversary is significant in the following sense. I think there's a certain level of maturity that comes in at that time. You've had enough experience, enough history, to at least know what problems you face in the past and how you overcome them. And that maturity, I think, is tremendous. It gives us a certain amount of introspection, credibility, and also recognition around the world for the quality that we have, which allows us to attract good students, good faculty members, and continues to help us in our pursuit of, I would say, excellent research.